together. It didn't work well at all. But imagine it as a live view magnification, but smaller, close to your eye, and with a little grain in low light. Now, the question is, you activate VR and the image gets a little more stable. And with a long lens, do not expect perfection. So I tried a 125mm lens, manual lens. Will that help you to actually nail focus, as they say? Let's see. So then I took these three images at three different speeds, 1/60th of a second, 1/30th of a second, 1/15th of a second. And I focused here on the letters. And the first observation is that we do not have camera shaking either of them. However, what we have is that this area here on the side is more in focus than the letters. So I said, how is this possible? Magnified live view 100%. Magnified live view 100%. And I missed focus in all three of the pictures. How is this possible? And I was careful about it. So then I shot a fourth one, the one on the right, on the lower right that you see. And it's much cleaner, right? And I focused in this case at 200% in the live view, 200%. And I got it right this time. And this is proven also because this area that is in focus in the other pictures is not as focused here. What is in focus is my intended target. Which means what? Don't really trust 100% magnification in live view. I would say don't, especially if your target is small, even if your target is in good contrast. It's going to fool your eyes probably. I would say go to 200 live view magnification if you're handheld and you want critical focus. Not 100%, it's not going to do you good, you see that. And I was equally careful in all four of them. Okay, so now let's move to lens change to 24-70 f4 at 1/4 of a second speed. Shaken slightly, shaken very slightly. I would say this could qualify as non-shaken, but this was, if this was the eye of a model, it would probably look as shaken. This one is clean, very nice. And this one is obviously very shaken. And of course, you're not going to see it like that on the back of your camera or something, right? The problem with high-resolution bodies is when you get very up close. And this is kind of like... there is a cutoff pointer with this VR, because you saw in the previous pictures it was stable up to 125 or something like that, but here we have 1/4 of a second and it's obviously shaken, 1 out of 4. At 1/8 of a second, none of them is shaken, but two of them, number 1 and number 3, are slightly out of focus, which is kind of weird because I focused on the R in all four of them. I didn't use tripod, I was handheld, right, to test the VR. So at 1/8 of a second, at 50 millimeters, with the 24-70, we do not have camera shake, but we have in low light, because this is low light, this is actually against the light, right? There is strong light from the window, but this is a dark area where I'm focusing, right? So we have here a little bit of a problem in focusing, because I do not see evidence of shake in any of them. So at 1/8 the camera is steady at 50 millimeters, okay, but the focus is only excellent in 1 out of 4. At 1/15th of a second, they're all good enough, with number 1 being the more in focus compared to the other three, but practically speaking, they all look the same except number 3, which could have been, could use a little better focus, right? Number three. But the others are quite sharp. So from 1/15 of a second and above at 50 millimeters, no problem. So you can very safely shoot at a half and even less than half, or maybe 1/3 of your focal length. This of course depends highly on the lens, right? I mean, I haven't tried this camera with an unstabilized 1000 millimeters, right? And at 1/25th of a second, no shaking problem in all of them, but number four has a little bit of focus issue now again. You see that? Now, this is always in high magnification. All right, very high magnification. So that's the thing now. And that is why many times I have my doubts about Tony's tests. Because you see what this can do. And I took one shot after the other. I click, 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 without doing anything on the camera in the meantime and focusing on the same point. So, I don't know. You judge for yourself. If Tony was comparing, let's say, two lenses, and this accidental click happened with the second of the lenses, he would say, oh, the first one is sharper. And now, with the D850 through its viewfinder with a Tamron 24-70 G2 with a Tamron stabilization on at 50 millimeters. So we have 1/30th of a second, 1/15th of a second, 1/8th of a second, and 1/4th of a second with the Tamron. And you can see here, well, it's only the ISO which went up here, obviously, and affected the noise a little bit, but I have the camera without correcting noise for high ISO, but I do not see any evidence of camera shake at any speed. In the next shot, somehow, I saw a little camera shake, though, with the D850 at 1/4 of a second. And you know why? I had turned on the electronic front curtain shutter. So apparently, this little delay that it does, this little unusual click-click that it does with the electronic front curtain shutter, it affected me. So the fully mechanical shutter apparently was more stable, because that's what I've been used to. It's always an interaction between you and the camera, right? For example, this is with fully electronic shutter on the D850, which is the silent live view mode, silent live view, in magnification as a matter of fact, and they're all shaken. So apparently the fully mechanical shutter yielded much better results. Again, I will repeat, that's because I, meaning my body, my hands, the whole thing, is used to interact with a mechanical shutter. It's kind of like the decisive moment, so to speak. While with a first curtain electronic shutter, or no shutter at all, no vibration feedback from the camera, full electronic recording, I don't know when the picture is taken. I don't know when the camera is actually recording the picture while my body is moving all this time, right? There is kind of like a feedback loop interaction between the photographer and the camera. And that is why the more you get used to a camera, the more stable you become with it. I have noticed, for example, that my D850 shots are now one full stop more stable than they were 1 year ago, because I got used to it. I know my body knows how to interact with it. So after various shots, these are my conclusions. At 1/4 of a second, the D850 with a Tamron G2 wins over the Z7. At 1/8 of a second, they're practically equivalent. Above that, they're absolutely equivalent. However, with the D850, for me to get better stabilization, I have to use full mechanical shutter. I also did not notice any meaningful difference with the Z7 if I turn on or off the first curtain electronic shutter. This is something that you have to test yourself and how your body reacts to the camera in this case. If I could summarize in my experience so far, focusing accuracy with manual lenses The king would be, of course, the camera on the tripod, loop, magnified live view. Whether you use DSLR or mirrorless, loop and magnified live view is going to save the day. And focus each time at the set aperture to avoid focus shifting, right? Now, without a tripod, any camera with a loop in magnified live view, 100% hit rate you're going to get, even without a tripod. Any camera, DSLR or mirrorless. It also provides very good stabilization because the loop is pressed against your head. And your head is acting like an excellent stabilization point in perfect synchronization with your eyes, because the camera is not moving up and down with a loop. It only moves backwards and forward according to how you move your head. It's absolutely amazing. Whoever's done it knows what I mean. But consider options for presbyopia here, because if you cannot see clearly up close, you start developing presbyopia, contact the manufacturer of the loop to give you options. Normally, through the loop, you should be seeing a crystal clear image, even the tiniest letters from a distance. Crystal clear, it's absolutely amazing. If you cannot see that with a loop, you probably have presbyopia, or your eyes do not agree with a specific loop, and you gotta consider other options. Zacuto, for example, has options for presbyopia, but you have to contact the company. Don't buy these used ones, the old ones from eBay, because you cannot change lenses with them inside the loop to adjust your eyes. Now, the second I would say is mirrorless through the viewfinder, 200%, as you saw. You're going to get about 95% hit rate, which is excellent. And I'm talking critical focus here, right? Not good enough, critical. Mirrorless through viewfinder at 100%, it's undetermined, really. It depends on how well you're used to it, especially on high-resolution bodies. But why am I saying high-resolution bodies? Because if this is what you see through the viewfinder, and then you magnify it at 100%, and you say everything is sharp in both images, right? And then you magnify it at 200%, and you say everything is sharp in both images, and you're happy. Okay, and everything may look fine. But with a high-resolution body, and this is 45 megapixels, and I chose, unfortunately, the right image to process finally print, because I had not done a careful comparison between the pictures in advance, and I thought they were all the same, right? And unfortunately, on an 18 by 24 print, 18 by 24, that's not so big, right? This planet here, I think this is Venus, is it? I don't know. Not that good in that. It looks like, it does look like a line on the print. And this looks like a line too. It actually destroys the print. It looks awful, awful. And on the print, you can actually see that this tree is blurred out. And I thought that was normal until I rechecked the other image where it's sharp. You're not going to see that in the viewfinder. And that's the problem nowadays, that a new product comes out in the market and everybody says, oh, the new product came out in the market, so everything old one now, everything previous to that is crap. It's either black or white. They're not really focusing on how to take the best picture that you can with whatever equipment you have, which you can. Both of these are with the D850, both of them. It's just that the right one seems to be a little more shaken because of the vibrations on my wooden floor on the tripod. You know, I was in a very uncomfortable position and the tripod was not set on all three legs, it was only on two legs, leaning out the window. And that induced a lot of factors of a shaken image, and that's a slight shake. It's nighttime, almost, I mean, it's early morning. It's a long exposure, long enough to capture the slightest vibration on a high-resolution body. So these things have to be said. I'll make a different video about that. Thanks a lot. Bye.